Today in the news, we got a UGO, some Intel graphics, and some bad reviews. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Last week, a benchmark for the RTX 2060 appeared on the Final Fantasy benchmark boards. Those numbers were showing a 30% boost in performance compared to the last generation GTX 1060. At the same time though, a new GPU simply called Nvidia graphics device showed up with a much higher score, but we don't know what this GPU could be. Here is my take on it. We know that the last generation GTX 1060 launched with two different models, the 3GB and the 6GB. The difference between the two using the Final Fantasy benchmark is around 16% in favor of the 6GB model, thanks to the higher CUDA core count and the bigger memory. What if Nvidia was doing the same thing with the RTX 2060? The difference between the RTX 2060 score and this Nvidia graphics device is around 19%, so I think that it might be plausible. That would put this new GPU at the same level of performance as a 1070 Ti, beating the 1070 and still staying shy of the 2070, just how Nvidia likes it. This could also be a new Quadro device though, so I won't get any further with the speculation. I'm just surprised that no one took time to talk about that specific device. Also, in graphics news, it seems like Intel will host a conference where they will discuss their GPU architecture. According to DigiTimes, Intel is planning to release a discrete graphics card in 2020, codenamed Arctic Sound. While many outlets reported that this would be a GPU-focused conference, Raja Koduri took to Twitter to sort of tone down the expectation, saying that this is an Intel architecture day, not a discrete GPU day. At least, this architecture day means that they will probably cover what they're working on the GPU side of things. Here is what their December 11th architecture day looks like. Since Intel's architecture hasn't really changed in the last 3 years, I hope we get something interesting out of it. Moving on, it seems like Microsoft is going to do whatever it takes to get away from Intel. A few months back, before the Surface Go released, it was revealed that this device was originally supposed to come equipped with an ARM processor. Apparently, Intel petitioned Microsoft heavily, and the Surface Go ended up with a Pentium Gold CPU instead. Well, according to a Microsoft insider, Brad Sams, Microsoft might release a new Surface laptop with AMD inside. This could also be the first appearance of AMD's Picasso APU. I wouldn't be surprised if the reason for this switch is due to Intel's continued delay on 10 nanometer. Process node changes usually have one consistent thing, and that is better power efficiency, and since AMD is jumping to 7 nanometers very soon, that might be the way to go for a lot of laptop and tablet makers. In gaming, it seems like Valve's new card game is having trouble with reviews. It launched about 2 days ago and it already has 1,500 negative reviews, giving it a mixed status on Steam. It's pretty interesting because the only reason why people are refunding the game is because of the whole monetization scheme. It was clear before the game launched that you would have to pay to get more cards, and waiting a day after launch would have given you a sense of how much you would need to spend to have a comfortable set. Anyways, the gameplay and mechanics are said to be really good with 2,600 positive reviews, but what comes with the game at the $20 price point is just not enough for you to fully enjoy it, apparently. Then in the benchmarking space, 3D Mark will have a new ray tracing benchmark called Port Royale. This benchmark will utilize the DXR API and feature some extreme poly count test scenes with real-time ray traced elements. The benchmark looks pretty good to test out reflections. I mean, all that glass and all of those lights will definitely put pressure on any GPUs, but I miss the days of really entertaining benchmarks like the Guru 3D one with the Godzilla cat shooting lasers out of its eyes. Yeah, those were the good old days. Anyways guys, that is pretty much it for the news. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Don't forget to pick up a thumbs up for the video on your way out and leave a comment if you have any questions or just want to add to the subjects we talked about today. You can click right here to see the latest video and right here to subscribe to the channel. That's pretty much what we always do. As usual, stay frosty and I'll see you on the next one.